had the opportunity of making a video on the Walk Away movement on their Facebook page. Just about prayer, praying for people and stuff. And I'll tell you that, you know, this Thanksgiving, there's some crazy stuff to actually be thankful for. It might sound a little weird, but it's kind of true. So many of us, you know, we have different opinions and we have different beliefs and ideas and the like. And we thought there were people in our lives that would be there and be our friends or family or whatever forever. I mean, we even thought that we would have certain jobs based off of our talent and stuff like that, or our tenure or whatever. And that we would be accepted for who we are in private, in public. And some of us found out that, no, there's relatives and friends and family and workplaces that really aren't like that. And you got to think about this, Kate. So it can be like, it can be almost backhanded. But the truth is, you want to know the truth about who people are. Now, you may not be like that, okay? But you might have had people in your life who you might have thought, well, they wouldn't be like that. But then you find out, no, they actually would be like that. They would be individuals who would scorn you or come at you or call you things or that type of thing. It's like, is it like me? I'm kind of like, give me the bad news first before you give me the good news. I've always been that way. In fact, I would rather have... I'd rather go through the hard trial to get to the better day than go to the better day than get to a hard trial. I'd rather do that. But sometimes, you know, this is the way life works. You got to go through some good stuff and then get to some bad. But my way is always go through the bad to get to the good. So right now, I'm going to tell you that just from that video, there are folks of you who I don't know. And I've added you as friends on here. And hopefully, you know, one day we get to know each other in person. But I'm thankful for people who in my life, who I've known, you know, for a long period of time, who have accepted me. I'm actually very, very thankful for that. I'm thankful for them accepting my faith, thankful for them accepting my friendship, thankful for them accepting my voice in their life. I'm thankful for that stuff. I'm thankful also that the people that weren't supposed to be there forever are no longer there. I'm actually thankful for that because, you know, I also don't like to waste my time. But I like to give my time to where my time is due, where I really want to be present. And so now I know who I can be present with and the people who I don't need to be present with. And that's actually a good feeling because I'm 44 years old and it's like me and my wife, we've been through so much and we know where we want to dedicate our time. And now it's a little bit more pointed. Like, you know, they say that as you get older, your circles might get a little bit smaller. Well, my circle kind of expands. I'm an extrovert, so my circle expands. But I also know, too, that there's people out there where it needs to get smaller. And so I've been able to make that decision, and they made that decision for me about who they actually are. And you can take that into, you know, this Thanksgiving season and really think about that. That there's people in your life who might have been like, I'm just being real with you, might have been dead weight, might have been pulling on you, might have been the taker. They might have been individuals who were really just using you. Using you for your influence, using you for your you know, popularity, your stance in society. They might have been using you for your money. They might have been using you for whatever, emotionally, psychologically, spiritually, whatever. And they're no longer a part of your life. You don't have to be sad about that. I mean, really. There's people that I'm like, okay, hey, I can pray for you and I hope that you do well, but I'm good. I don't have to worry about that individual anymore. And that's not like malicious. It's not like spiteful. It's kind of like, okay, cool. At least I know. Like I said, I'd rather know than not know. And you have that as well. You might have had people in your life, and it doesn't matter what your political stance is, it doesn't matter what your societal stance is, all that stuff. It's just like there's people in your life that maybe didn't belong there, that maybe you had to have a hard conversation and there's been a breakaway. And if there's a breakaway, be thankful for that. You mourn what could have been. Okay, that's what so many of us struggle with, is what could have been, what we thought should have been, what, you know, what we thought in our imagination was going to be reality. And it's not reality. Reality is something very different. And that reality is actually better for you because you're not putting your energy into something that's going to waste your time. Because time is precious, y'all. Time is really, really precious. And so as you take that into 2021, just remember that your friendships are precious. The people who really care about you, they are precious. And how you interact with them, that's a precious thing as well. So when you go in to think about this and you go into this holiday and there's folks who you've decided, hey, I'm going to see. I don't care what the folks say. I'm just going to do it. just remember that your time with them is precious as well. And you only get a certain amount of time. Time is not something that waits for any person. It's not anything that waits for any situation. Things change rather quickly. And when they do change, you don't get that time back. And when you don't get that time back, I'm not trying to look at things in regret. Because I know that there are folks in my life who I want to dedicate my time to. Like, I'm dedicating my time to speaking into your life, which is why you've allowed me to that opportunity, which I appreciate. So it's not actually what I'm building as well too with my business, because you've allowed me that opportunity to speak into your life. And that's precious to me, because I don't want to speak ill. I don't want to speak falseness. I don't want to speak lies. I want to speak the freaking truth. And I want to be a person that you can rely on for that. But you've also been that for me if you're still in my life right now. And I appreciate that. And I'm thankful. I'm actually very, very thankful for that. For the new people who I don't know and I'm going to get to know over time, I can't wait to get to know you. And I can't wait to at least be a part of your life in this way. And I'm hoping that we can have a mutual relationship in that. So you as a person on that couch right now, you have an opportunity to look at 2020 in a thankful position, a thankful place. I'm thankful that there's people that have stood by me. And I'm thankful there's people that have supported me. I found out that some of the friends that I had weren't actually friends. I also found out that the people that I didn't think were actually my friends turned out to be my friends. That's a precious thing. It's very, very precious. And so I'm thankful for you, and I'm thankful for this opportunity to speak into your life. All right? Remember, the folks on the TV, they're ready to take away your friendships in your life and all the other fun stuff in your personal relationships, because they think that they can control you. But you on the other side of that, you know that they don't. They can't control your personal relationships. They can't control your life. You control you. Take care. Be safe.